Okay, great.
Okay. And then as always with this class, just be mindful to move at your own pace, listen to your body. If you want to take things faster or increase your weight, that's always there for you. If you feel like you need to slow down or move slower in order to keep proper alignment and form and everything, then you could do that too. Okay. Oh, I'm going to go ahead and mute everybody. If you've got any questions, feel free to unmute yourself or type into the chat box. And we'll just come back to a seated or standing grounded position of some sort. And we'll just drop right into the body scan today. So I'll have you close your eyes. And let's start by putting one hand on the belly and one hand on the low back, if you're able to reach your low back. Otherwise, both hands can go to the low belly. And just noticing where your breath is, where your inhale is. And we're going to walk through your three axes today. So I just want you to start by finding your vertical axes, that top to bottom one, stretching all the way from your tail up and out through the top of your head. And see if you could just make that axis a little bigger. Can you sit a little taller? Can you maybe even lengthen the back of your neck, reaching the crown of your head up towards the sky? And just feeling that opposition of your feet or your sit bones grounded in the floor, and then your head reaching up. And then I want you to find your side axes. So going from your left to your right. And I want you to try to expand your body into that axis. So think of broadening and opening your shoulders up left to right. You can even think of breathing into the sides of your ribs to broaden the middle part of your ribs. And just taking up space in that direction. And then lastly, find that axis forward to back. And for this one, I just want you to notice where your weight is shifted. So whether you're standing or seated, do you feel like you're leaning forward, leaning back? Do you feel like you're stacked right on top of your sit bones? And see if you could just find that nice balance in between from the front to the back. And just thinking of taking up as much space in the room as you can in those three axes. We'll take one more inhale, one more exhale, and we'll open the eyes. Okay, let's reach the hands up towards the sky. We'll interlace the fingers if you're able to. Let everything shrug up and then take that into a nice articulating roll as close to the ground as you can. Let's pause at the bottom here. Find a few breaths into your back. And then on your next exhale, we'll roll all the way back up. Good. We'll slide the hands behind the head. You can also cross the arms in front of the chest if that's easier. We'll take a side bend to the left. And then pause here and breathe into your open ribs. And then exhale, come back to the center. Yeah, side bend. Take an inhale into the open ribs. And then exhale, center. Side bend, inhale. Exhale, center. Side bend, inhale. Exhale, center. Good. So I'm going to have you side bend again to the left. You're going to stay in that side bending position. You're going to rotate down towards the floor and then up to the ceiling, but stay in that side bend the whole time. It's okay if you don't get very far. Rotate down and rotate up. Rotate down, rotate up. And then come all the way back to the center. If you need your hands down your lap for this one, you can do that too. Good, side bend to the right. Same thing here, rotate down, stay in the side bend, rotate up, rotate down and up. Last one, rotate down and up, and then all the way back to the center. Bring your arms out into the sides, palms facing down. Yeah, we're gonna rotate left, and I want you to look at your back hand and then center, and then rotate right. Again, looking at your back hand and center. Yep, rotate left and center, rotate right and center. Okay, I'm gonna layer on with this one. If you're able to lean forward as you do this one, I'm gonna have you lean forward. Otherwise, you can stay with just the rotation. So I'm gonna lean forward as I rotate. So right hand touches either left knee or left ankle. And I rotate, my hand is still kind of reaching up and back behind me. And then I come back to the center, seated tall. Yep. And then switching directions, rotate left hand to right ankle or knee, looking at the hand reaching up and back behind you, and then back to the center. Yeah, this move is called saw. This is a Pilates move. I want you to almost imagine like your body's finding a saw to the right and a saw to the left. Maybe hard to see this one, but it's there. Okay, and just find a nice, even, smooth pace, rotating down in one direction, stacking tall, rotating down into the other direction. Yeah, let's just do a couple more here. And last one. Yep, and then back to the center. You're gonna give yourself a big hug, round your upper back. Take a breath into that area in between the shoulder blades. And then inhale, open the arms, open the chest. Yep. Exhale, give yourself a hug, rounding the spine. Sorry, I think I got the breath mixed up. And then exhale, we're going to open the chest. Yeah. Inhale, give yourself a hug to close the chest. And exhale to open. Mm-hmm. Inhale, hug. And exhale, open. You might even feel a nice stretch in between the shoulder blades as you breathe into that area. Yeah, let's do one more. Inhale, hug. And exhale, open. Good. Go ahead and shake the arms out. You can shake the legs out if you're standing. Okay, good. We're gonna do these with no weights at first, just coming into a bit of an overhead press and then finding some different angles. So once you get into that overhead press position, elbows are bent. And then you're gonna press the arms directly overhead, look up at the sky. And then you're gonna lower the arms down either to your knees or to the ground. Sit tall again, overhead press that invisible weight above your head. And then lean forward, tap the ground or your knees. And then back to a sitting position. Yeah. So it's like you're pushing the sky away from you and then you're pushing the floor away from you. Push the sky away from you. Push the floor away from you. Mm-hmm. Really reaching in both directions. You can let your shoulders and your ribs shrug up as you do this one. And then pressing your hands into the floor when you go down. Yeah, that's nice, everybody. Let's do a couple more here. And last one. Good, and back to the center. Good, we'll take the hands behind us, interlace the fingers if you're able to, open up the chest one last time. And then give one last shake to the arms, to the upper body, and to the legs if you can. Okay. Let's jump right into today. So we've got enough time for the circuit. Okay, so you'll see in the chat box, Sarah Dawn posted, and actually I'm just gonna do that. I'm just gonna repost this one more time in case you have a hard time seeing my screen here. We're doing another pyramid today, or by another, I mean we haven't done this one in a while, but if you were with me maybe a few months ago, we were doing some pyramids. So it's going to be a 17-minute pyramid, making sure you can see my screen there. There's going to be seven exercises, but You work your way up in repetitions up to the fourth exercise, and then you work your way back down as you get to the seventh exercise. Similar to our other circuits though, try to remember how many rounds you get through. A round being completing exercise one all the way through exercise seven. And then if you want to share that at the end, you can. Okay, first exercise, these should all be somewhat familiar if you've been joining me regularly. Let's see, don't need the weights for this one, but I'm gonna keep them near me. It's gonna be 5 burpees. Okay, so for my seated athletes, yeah, as a reminder here, feel free to do these with me. Leaning forward, tapping the ground. If that's unrealistic for you, remember you can always tap your knees or your thighs, and then clapping the hands overhead, okay? And you're just moving quickly back and forth between that. Hinging, when you lean forward, I want you to try to keep your back as flat and as neutral as you can. It's okay if the back needs to round, but try to keep it flat, as flat as you can. And then clapping the hands overhead, and you're quickly just doing 5 of those, and then you'll move right into the next movement. Yeah. For those of you practicing, you can keep practicing. Standing athletes, you have a couple of options here. If you're unable to get down to the floor, you can always just lean forward, tap the floor, and then stand tall and clap the hands overhead. If you are able to get down on the floor, you're gonna come forward, hands come in front of the feet. You can step or hop your feet back. You can then add a push up here if you're able to. You don't have to if you can't. You can step or hop the feet back in, standing tall. And then as you clap the arms overhead, you jump into the air, okay? So coming down to the ground, push up, and then clapping up overhead. But remember, you can do as much of that burpee as you're able to. You don't have to do the full thing. Okay, you're gonna move right from there. You're gonna pick up the weights and you're gonna hold on to the weights for the next 2 exercises. So you've got 10, am I saying that right? Yeah, yes, 10 reverse flies. Open this here. 10 reverse flies. So this will look similar for seated and standing athletes. So hinging forward at the hips, remember to keep a slight bend in the elbows here, and then pulling the arms out into a T and lowering the arms back down. Okay, so we're really focusing on those muscles in between the shoulder blades, really the entire back. Remember to keep your neck long here, trying to open up the chest and engage the back. Make sure I'm saying this right. Yes. Standing athletes are going to be doing the same thing. Slight bend in the knees. Find a hip hinge forward. And you're doing the same movement. 10 reverse flies. Try not to use momentum on these. Try to keep the whole movement really controlled. Okay. Third exercise is going to be 15 overhead press. So just holding on to the same weights. Or you can bump up the weights if you'd like, pressing the weights directly overhead and then back down to shoulder height. Yeah. Oh, you know what? Hang on. Sorry, I switched this for today. I want your palms facing forward for this one. So palms will be forward for this overhead press. Yeah, it works the same general set of muscles. It just slightly challenges you when we turn the hands in a certain direction. So it's going to be an exhale to press overhead and an inhale to return back to the start. Standing athletes, you have the option to do squats here. You can just hold on to that set of weights and drop right down into a set of 15 squats. I keep forgetting that I slightly changed some of these when I was recording this morning. So we're going to go feet a little bit wider than hip distance apart and feet and hips slightly turned out. Okay, so just finding a different angle for our squats today, just to find some variation through the hip mobility and the hip joint. Okay, so that's your third exercise. Fourth exercise, this is kind of the peak, meaning that it's the most repetitions. Oh yeah, heavy or light. For the overhead, so if you have 2 different sets of weights, I would do a lighter set for the reverse fly and a heavier set for the overhead press. But if you can keep that heavier set of weights for the reverse fly, if you're able to do that, then go for it without losing your form. Otherwise, do lighter for the reverse flies and heavier for the overhead press. Yeah, that's a good question. Okay, fourth exercise, you're gonna be doing no weights. This is punches for my seated athletes. Okay, you know this all too well because this is one of my faves. So thumb over the fingers and as if you're punching a punching bag directly in front of you. Really quick, left, right, left, right, left, right. Okay, again, my reminder whenever we're doing punches is to not just do this from the shoulders, but to really let your whole upper body and torso rotate as you punch left, right, left, right. Okay, so that twisting rotation is really good for your spine. And if you were throwing a punch, it would be a little bit more natural. You want your body to rotate. 40 punches each side. So right, left is one, right, left is two. Okay, standing athletes are gonna be doing quick feet. Standing athletes have a couple of options. You can do punches, just standing punches, if you wanna do that. If you wanna bring more lower body in, we're gonna be doing quick feet, moving the feet forward and back as if you were jumping over an invisible line. We're going for quickness, not necessarily the height of your jump. Okay, so just moving the feet quickly back and forth. Same idea, right foot forward and then left foot forward counts as one, right left counts as two. Okay, then you start to work your way back down the pyramid. So then you go fifth exercise, is back to 15 overhead press and or squats. Sixth exercise is 10 reverse flies with that lighter set of weights. And then seventh exercise, did I say that right? Yes. Wait, sorry, let me just make sure. Okay, great, great. And then seventh exercise is back to your five burpees, okay? So then once you finish those five burpees, you go back to the beginning, which is another five burpees. So you're basically be doing 10 burpees in a row. And then moving through that again. Remember, one round is seven exercises. Okay. I think I got everything. Sometimes I don't trust my handwriting, but it's pretty sure it's right today. Let me know if you have any questions. You have 17 minutes for this. So as many rounds as you can in 17 minutes. I'm going to start you off and then I'm going to start my music. If anything starts to glitch, I'll turn the music off. But my signal looks strong, so I think we'll be good. Okay, so you're starting with five burpees. No weight for the burpees. Unless you want to add weight, then by all means, go for it. Five burpees, and then you go right into your 10 reverse flies and your 15 overhead press. So have those weights ready. Okay, again, I'll start you off, and then in a couple minutes, I'll turn the music on. All right, here we go. 17 minutes, on your marks, get set, and go. Starting with those five burpees. And then 10 reverse flies and 15 overhead press. Yeah, if you need to do the reverse flies single arm instead of double arm, you can totally do that. You'll just be doing five on each side instead of 10 total. Yeah. Remember for the overhead press, sorry, I was just doing this wrong. For the overhead press, you'll finish at your shoulders. So it's just a strict overhead press. Keep your palms facing forward. I switched everything up today, but I'm forgetting. Exhale to press overhead. Inhale to lower down. Yep, right from there into 40 punches or 40 quick feet on each side. Nice work, everybody. You're 2 minutes in, you got 15 minutes left. Find a good pace, something you can sustain for these last 15 minutes here. All right, let's see if I can get some music going. Are you able to hear that? If I don't open the door, kinda hard to believe. Gotta have faith in me. Gotta freak out.
Look at me.
Get down.
Look at me.
Freak out.
Look at me now. Cause all I ever wanted was love.
You're 6.5 minutes in, everyone. 6.5 minutes in. 10 minutes in, you've got 7 minutes left. 7 minutes left.
I do my hair toss, check my nails. Baby, how you feeling?
Feeling good as hell.
Hair toss, check my nails. Baby, how you feeling?
Feeling good as hell.
Woo, child, tired of the bullshit. Gone, dust your shoulders off. Keep it moving, yes, Lord. Trying to get some new shit in there. Swimwear, going to the pool shit. Come now, come dry your eyes. The sky. I know that it's hard, but you have to try. If you need advice, let me simplify. If he don't love you anymore, just walk your fine ass out the door. I do my hair toss, check my nails. Baby, how you feeling? Hair toss, check my nails. Baby, how you feeling?
Feeling good as hell.
Baby, how you feeling? Change your life. You can have it all, no sacrifice. I know we did you wrong, we can make it right. So go and let it all hang out tonight. Cause we don't love you anymore. So walk your fine.
You have 4 minutes left, everyone. 4 minutes left. Looking good. You have 1 minute, last minute. How many more can you get through? Okay, sorry, abrupt stop, but my Spotify froze. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Nice work, everybody. Go in and grab some water. Take a break. The reverse flies got me. I don't know about all of you, but I feel like I'm going to feel that tomorrow. I've also, because I've upgraded from my soup cans to my 3-pound weights, everything feels harder. So here we are. Alrighty, while you're grabbing water, if you feel like sharing how many rounds you got through, go ahead and unmute yourself, or you can type into the chat box. Yes, we've got the SFVA. Love having you all. With 6 rounds times 4 veterans and 1 staff. That is awesome. Thank you for sharing. We've got a crew over there. We've got Kate with 5 rounds. Oh, sorry, Kenzie, I missed you with 5 rounds. Nice work, you too. Cindy with 5 rounds. A lot of 5 rounds in here. Yeah, I see some people trying to add, so I'll give another minute or so. Okay, we'll keep... keep sharing if you'd like. Stella with 5 rounds. Thanks for sharing, Stella. Wow, we've had 5 across the board. We must have all been at the same pace here. Minus the VA, they outed us with 6 rounds. Cool. All right, well, thanks for sharing. Let's jump into a cool down. We've got a little bit of extra time for a cool down. So that's always nice. Make sure this is good. Okay. All right, so I'll have you come back to a seated or standing grounded position here. Okay, so let's have hands on the lap. If you're standing, you can just kind of be in this crouched down position, hands just above your knees. And you're gonna lower your chest down towards your knees and just rest your chest on your hands. I want you to tuck your chin into your throat, lengthening the back of the neck. And then pushing your hands into your thighs, you're just gonna push to the right so your body rotates to the left. Really just trying to go for a slight side of the rib stretch here. If you don't feel it, that's okay. And then come back to the center. Again, let your chest relax onto your hands, onto your knees. And then tuck your chin into your throat, lengthen the back of your neck. And then we'll rotate the other way. So pushing your hands to the left, rotating to the right, taking an inhale into the base of your ribs. And then back to the center, let your chest and your head hang heavy this time. And then we'll come back up to a seated position. Good. We're gonna stack one forearm on top of the other like you've got genie arms. Yep, let's rotate to the left. And then I want you to pull that elbow. So let's see, I'm sorry, I've got my left stacked over my right and I'm pulling my right elbow just slightly across my chest as I rotate. And then same thing the other way, rotate, grabbing that elbow, opening up that area in between the shoulder blades as I rotate. Let's just do one more time each side. Rotate, pulling the arm across the chest. And then rotate, pulling the other arm across the chest. Good, and then back to the center. We'll bring both arms up to the ceiling. If you're able to open and close your hands, circle the wrists around. Yeah, and then I want you to pull your fingers down to the ground so we get a stretch over the top of the wrist. And then lean forward, pulling the arms behind you, kind of up and back behind you. Keep pulling the fingers down towards the forearms. And then sit tall, lift the hands up again, give the wrists a few circles. Yeah, and then just one more time, pull the fingers down, lean forward, pull the arms behind you, opening the chest. And then sitting tall, we'll interlace the fingers this time if you're able to. Bringing that into an articulating roll down to the floor. Take an inhale at the bottom, and then exhale, roll yourself up. Good, and let's just bring that right into a backstroke. You can look at the hand behind you, just moving slow here. A lot of rotation today. Okay, and then we'll come back to the center. Let's give the arms a shake. You can give the legs a shake. All right, we'll still the body. We'll close the eyes. Find your breath again. You can create a sandwich with your lower belly, one hand on the lower belly, one hand on the back if that feels okay. And then we'll just find those three axes again in your body. So finding that vertical axis, going up and down. So feeling either your feet or your sit bones anchor down as the crown of your head reaches up. So find as much length through your spine as you've got. And then finding that left to right axis. Can you open the shoulders? Can you broaden the ribs with your inhale? Just taking up as much space in that area. And then lastly, just noticing where your weight is in that forward to back plane. You can even play with it, maybe rocking your weight or shifting your weight forward and back, and just seeing what feels comfortable, what feels like your spine is stacked one on top of itself. And then hold somewhere in that balanced position. So you're thinking of expanding yourself three-dimensionally, up and down, left to right, forward to back. Go ahead and think of one thing you're grateful for today. We'll take one more inhale, one more exhale, and we'll open the eyes. Awesome. Thank you so much for joining me today, everybody. Happy Tuesday. Oh, I see a few more numbers in here. We've got Sheila with 3.5 rounds. Nice work, Sheila. Yeah, and then Stefania, and if I apologize if I'm not pronouncing your name right. Can't count while I'm doing it. That's the story of my life. I never know how many rounds I'm doing. So yeah, I hear you. Awesome. Cool. All right. Well, hey, thank you so much for coming today, everybody. Happy Tuesday. Be safe. Stay healthy. I'll see you either Thursday at 11 or next Tuesday. No new announcements, but I'll stick around for questions if folks have questions. Otherwise, have a great rest of your week.
Thank you, Rachel.
Thanks, Rachel. Yeah, of course.
Yep.
Bye.
Bye. Rachel.